Welcome to SA Music Box, right here on Hot TV. Our special guest tonight is Shamela Miller, actress from Girl from St. Agnes, a brand new series on Showmax, and she'll be unpacking her music box. Very contemporary, very cool. Check it out. Shamela is a great acting talent and stars in the new Showmax series called Girl from St. Agnes, and also recently played Athena in Troy, Fall of a City, which was on Netflix. Another wonderful series. Welcome to SA Music Box.
Thanks.
So you know we're going to talk about your top three songs in SA right now.
Yes.
Is that like intimidating or is it?
No, because I have my top three songs. I know what they are.
Oh, so you're like well prepared.
I'm like super well prepared.
Wow.
This is how I roll.
You gave it a bit of thought and you thought, okay, let me lock in.
Yeah.
And pick three.
Yeah. It was difficult picking three. Yeah. I'm not going to lie. So I had six. And then I had to kind of like...
Narrow it down slowly.
The
culling phase, as they call it.
Yeah.
So just a few years ago, I remember seeing you on Top Actor. You and I had a chat. We met through a mutual friend, Ruben Collin.
Yes.
And
shout out to Ruben.
Yes, shout out to Ruben Collin, if you were listening to this. And then you were on Isidingo.
Yes.
Which we cast you on, which was... what was that first experience for you on Isidingo?
On Isidingo. Well, it was because I talk about this story all the time because people are like, how was it being on Isidingo? How did you get there? And I always say there was kind of a hustle on my part in like getting onto the show because I didn't do it through an agent or anything.
Yeah.
The casting, et cetera, whatever. I just like got myself on tape, et cetera, et cetera. But what people don't know is that you were... the catalyst to all of that because you introduced me to, you know, the EP, etc., got me the audition, got me on tape and all of that. So that was cool.
Hey, Sean, you heard that, right? it's now recorded. Now, I realize that all my excitement of getting into the studio, because I was very excited to have you here, that we started this particular interview, and for the audience listening, we started without our headphones on. So we're going to just quickly put our headphones on so that we can hear.
So we can hear us.
Yes.
Is this mine?
Yes, it is. Cool. And yeah, exactly. So that's much better. Hey, Sean, it looks cool. Exactly.
Now we look professional.
Yeah. So I saw the trailer for Girl from St. Agnes recently. I thought the trailer was amazing. You play a very prominent part in the trailer. And I've obviously since worked out that you play a very prominent part in the series itself. Mm-hmm. Tell us about the series and tell us about your role.
Well, the series is a murder mystery. It's like a whodunit murder mystery. So there's a death and there are different suspects for the death basically every single episode.
Yeah.
And you're on this rat chase to, I don't know if rat chase is the right term, but you're on this chase to find the killer.
Like a Cluedo board game, but with a lot more depth. And
Yes. And a lot of dark secrets and that come out of this school and the people that... attend that work there, etc. It's very dark.
Yeah.
It's very fast paced also. It's eight episodes long, so it's like perfect binge material. It's really cool. And then the character I play is Jenna Galloway. And she's your, I think, now typical, like a mean girl. She's really popular, but she's also incredibly smart.
Yeah.
So she's top of the class and needs to stay there. She's this scholarship kid, but she acts like she's
regular Joe,
like she acts like she's top of the range.
Oh, living on
the top of the hill.
Yeah.
Darling, you can't touch me. She does have her own demons. She she suffers from anxiety, etc., and there's a lot of things in the show that happen that basically turn her on her head, and she goes from being like mean girl to changing.
Obviously not literally it's a metaphor.
It's a metaphor.
Which obviously that's exactly what I thought.
Yeah.
When you said it. So okay, that's wonderful. I mean, during the shoot, which I assume was about a 2 month period.
Yeah.
You mentioned to get yourself into the groove and things, do you listen to a lot of music while the shoot's happening?
There's music playing like around usually. In the wardrobe or in makeup, etc. The only time I listen to music...
What type of music? Like Buddha Bar and things like that?
No, well, it's whoever's playing it. So there's like different people all the time. So it depends. It depends who brought the speaker to set.
Okay.
Who will control the music.
Yeah, like in the school, whoever brings the speaker controls the playlist.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, that's it.
And that's how it is in life as well. But I would listen to like sad, melancholy music to get into the mood of like really hectic scenes. Also to drown out the noise. There's a lot of noise on set all the time. Mm. So if you need to focus on a very like hectic emotionally or mentally or physically or whatever scene, there's a set is so busy all the time. There, you know, extras everywhere and makeup and wardrobe and like crew everywhere.
Yeah.
So I listen to music to drown out the sound to focus.
Okay, that's very cool.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if there was an artist who really got your attention while you were doing this year, I mean, recent artists, we were just talking about SA Music and the quality and how great the quality of SA Music is. Is there any particular artist who's really got your attention at the moment?
Who has got my attention at the moment?
Obviously musically.
But yeah.
Why would it be anything else?
Yeah. Why would I? You don't open up that box. That's a deep box, right?
That's a different box.
Yeah, that's different boxes.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm really, really, this has been happening for a long time, but I'm really into Shakira's sound. I feel like her, from where she started, like her voice is so phenomenal. And I'm liking the journey of her music. There's this little girl from Cape Town named Dope St. Jude.
Oh, yes. Actually, I saw that you sent it to me on your list yesterday. She's fantastic. Very raw.
Very raw.
Yeah.
You can hear that she's from like Cape Town, Western Cape. And yeah, she's just like, she's cool. Yeah.
I wish I could have played that track on the station, but it was, what is the word?
Explicit.
Explicit.
Yeah.
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 As far as lyrical content.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Not safe for radio.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So we didn't go this. Okay, so we've come to that point where you get to pick your first song for SA Music Box.
So that's me. Cool.
Yes.
I should go. So the first song, I'm throwing it back. I think this track is like 10 years old.
Yeah.
It's a band that I absolutely love and loved. Like I follow them around Cape Town and they're called Stealing Love Jones. And this track is called Kicks.
Okay, that's a wonderful choice. I love how, before we play the song, you said it's really old, about 10 years old, right? So like for me, really old is like 40 years old. And for you, really old is 10.
Okay,
but
yeah,
okay, caught. I suppose it does fall into the older.
Oh, it's older, right. Yeah.
All right, this is Shamila Miller's first choice for SA Music Box. It's a song called Kicks by Stealing Love Jones. You get your kicks. Lips are on my fingertips. You got me running away. You get your kicks. Oh, I love your silly tricks. You got me running away. Now it is Friday, and tonight we'll be cruising on the highway. I got money in my pocket, cause it's payday. Tonight we're gonna kick it on the town. Welcome back, Shamila. So I have another question for you, because I've seen you in a lot of drama. You've been in a lot of drama recently.
I've always been in drama.
Yes.
That's like the only thing I've been in.
Yes. So, which begs my next question. Would you ever do comedy?
I would love to do comedy. If I, it's also about like opportunities, you know, castings that open up, etc.
Sean to just to make a note of that. Because then.
Yeah, I would love to do it. I think for me, I have a very specific type of humor and maybe comic timing. So, yeah. I kind of have to balance that out, like a character with me, and then see what works. But yeah, I would love it.
Now, fantastic. The reason I asked, obviously, because I think there's a great opportunity in South Africa for a lot more comedy. And also, I know you.
Mm.
And you are very funny.
I am.
In person.
I am, yeah.
Always.
But I don't know if that translates on screen all the time. That's the thing.
I suppose I don't know either. I think I'm funny off screen and I have no idea if it translates on screen.
Right.
But you're right, timing is everything.
Yeah.
Whether in love or in comedy or in whatever you're doing, you get one thing wrong and next thing, you know, you have an 18-year-old. So, I'm just saying, that's timing. That's, you know.
Are you talking about the pull-out method or something? Yeah.
the rhythm method.
The rhythm method.
Yes. So what is the most important thing that you think you've learned in your career so far about this industry?
The biggest thing is that I need to follow my gut more. I lost out on a very big opportunity. Actually, like looking back, I don't know what I would have done differently.
Yeah.
But I lost out on an opportunity because of timing, because of scheduling, because of, you know, that. And it's something that absolutely broke my heart. And it broke my heart when I turned the project down. And, you know, I had a lot of people from the outside saying, you know, this is the better move. But in my heart, I knew what I wanted
Your
to do.
Your instinct told you one
my
thing.
My instinct, my gut told me do this. But I had a lot of pressure from other sides saying, no, this is, you know, the better option. I know myself. I know what I feel. I should trust my instinct, my gut. Yeah.
That's the advice I would always give you. I think in this industry, it's a lot about feel. And especially in the area that you're in the acting profession, or whether you're a musical performer, it's the same thing. Trust your instinct, trust your gut. Everyone around you, I think, will always have an opinion of what they think is best for you.
Yeah.
But no one knows what's
no
best
one
for
knows,
you.
No one knows, yeah. So, and you know.
Yeah.
Like, even if you don't know, you kind of know.
Yeah, no, exactly. So what is your second song for your SA Music Box?
My second song is I think it's fairly new. It's called Whipped. And it's by Teleman. Featuring Shakina and Nasty C.
That's a great song choice. I featured it on the show a few weeks ago, and I think I made a comment. It's one of the best grooves that I think I've ever heard come from South Africa.
Yeah.
It's just such a cool track.
Yeah, I love it.
So that is Shamila Miller's second choice for SA Music Box. It's Whipped by Teleman featuring Shakina and Nasty C. Wow, that was a cool track and a cool choice, Shamila. Thank you for that. I can listen to that song all day, every day. I have no problem with it. So, present company aside, who have you worked with that has the best... This is a serious question, obviously. Present company aside, who have you worked with that has the best sense of humor?
Wow, that's a tough one because it's, you know, it's so...
I said present company aside.
But that gap is really big, right?
Oh, okay, I see.
Wow, okay. I would have to say, so we only worked on a commercial together. We haven't worked in any, I think we did a few days on the docket as well. But he's a really dear friend of mine. His name's Clifford Joshua Young.
Okay.
And it's not so much that he's got a great sense of humor, but also he's just really witty.
Right.
And really quick, but in the cringiest way like imaginable.
Edge of your seat stuff.
Like, you never know what's going to come out of his mouth. And also, you never know if you're going to cringe so hard because he says something inappropriate.
Yeah.
And I laugh at him with him all the time.
He sounds like my type of guy.
Yeah, no. Yeah. He's a funny one, that one.
All right. I mean, we were talking about roles out there. Now, South Africa has become quite marginalized from a TV point of view, and as a producer of TV, I know that for a fact. In terms of, with the unfortunate background of our country, roles are quite heavily segmented in terms of white, colored, Indian, black, etc. Mm-hmm. Right. So, for you particularly, do you think there are enough quality roles out there for you?
I think maybe in the future. Right now, it's a bit. I'm also English speaking, so it makes it a bit more difficult in this country. English shows aren't as heavily produced.
Yeah.
Obviously, because most of our population is, you know, speaks Vernac, etc., or Afrikaans. Mm. So that already takes me out of a large chunk of work. And then, you know, there are a lot of quality actresses that are, you know, fantastic, that look and sound and everything, maybe even like me.
Yeah.
So to compete for a quality role, there's never gonna be enough.
It's always a challenge. I suppose when that profile pops up on an agent's desk,
and
you end up in an audition, you tend to get a sense of the same people ending up.
Exactly.
So it's very competitive.
It's very competitive, and And I mean, I think in the acting world, generally worldwide, it's always, the market's always going to be saturated from the actor's point of view. You know, there's always going to be too few roles and too many actors to go around. Yeah. But I don't know if that's ever going to change.
I think that's the same all over the world.
Yeah.
But I think where shows like Girl from St. Agnes, and I've just seen Shadow on Netflix that started.
Oh, yeah.
That's creating an opportunity for global audiences where it's English-based medium. And it's about, and that's what I'm creating a lot of, are shows and series which tell African stories in English that can translate around the world.
Yeah, and it's amazing.
That's where the opportunities are, isn't it? To overcome these particular challenges.
And especially now that Netflix is open to South Africa, etc., and that, you know, Shadow's the first, and it just opens up so many doors. And now I think more producers are like, oh, our audience can get so much bigger. So it's a good start.
Yeah, I mean, we from a zero gravity point of view are working with multiple US studios at the moment on various concepts, selling the same thing, you know, just talking to them about big African ideas that can be received by the entire world, but also looking at our country from a much more agnostic point of view, is that everyone in our country has a role to play.
Yeah.
And they're different stories from different people. And
exactly.
So it's not as tightly cast as a lot of the local shows are.
Have always been.
Yes, exactly. So I hope to see a lot more of you in these international shows, because I truly believe that with your talent and the quality of your acting, that you are going to move from strength to strength with series like this. And this type of show is going to put you on the map on a much larger scale.
Thanks.
And I suppose everyone has to know, right?
Yeah.
That brings us to your last choice for SA Music Box.
Yeah. I absolutely love this song. Like, every time it plays in my car on the radio, I turn it up all the way loud, because it's such a feel-good song. It is a Goldfish song, and the title is No One Has to Know.
You heard it right there from Shamila Miller, No One Has to Know by Goldfish. Well, Shamila, it was an absolute joy having you in the studio.
Thanks.
You made Sean laugh.
I'm glad.
Sean's manning the cameras for the listeners behind the scenes, which you get to see in a couple of weeks or in a week from now. It was absolute pleasure having you.
Yeah, and, it's cool being here. Thanks for the invite.
You're absolutely welcome.
Yeah.
We needed to, because I felt that just me being in the studio, you know, I've got like a radio face.
Right.
So I thought, let's just balance the thing out a bit.
Because there are cameras there, you're like, oh, we need to...
Let's be fair to the audience.
Right, yeah, yeah. They're going to tune in
exactly
more now. Because they'll be like, oh, wow.
But thank you for gracing us with your three songs. I think they're three wonderful choices.
Thanks.
I hope the audience and listeners, I hope you enjoyed it out there. And we hope to see you soon. And good luck with the series. I hope it's successfully received and you get great acclaim for it.
Thanks.
Cheers.
Yay. Bye.
Bye-bye. And that concludes another episode of SA Music Box. That was our special guest, Shamila Miller. And she shared what was in her SA Music Box. And we wish her all the best. She's a talented actress and a wonderful human being. Thank you for being on the show.